Welcome to the Forest Lake Area High School's 110th Annual Commencement Ceremony. At this time, parents, please join the graduates. Stand for our Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States. Please remain standing for the national anthem sung this evening by the Forest Lake Area High School Choir under the direction of Mr. John Guidry. Thank you. You may be seated. Dr. Massey, members of the school board, honored guests, friends, family, and most importantly, the class of 2021. It is my distinct and sincere honor to welcome you to the 110th Annual Forest Lake Area High School's Commencement Ceremony. I am Jim Caldwell, principal of the Forest Lake Area High School. To the class of 2021, it's good to see you gathered in one space where I can actually see your faces. High school graduation is an occasion that marks for many a transition into adulthood. Normally, getting to this momentous occasion is relatively smooth, but COVID had made this transition anything but. The class of 2021 has much to be proud of. In the face of a worldwide pandemic, you have earned $2 million in scholarships and grants. 3,061 hours of confirmed volunteer service, 5 conference titles, 8 team section titles, 8 team state appearances, 55 individual state tournament appearances, 2 state runner-ups, and 1 team state champion. There are many words that come to mind that could describe the class of 2021. Words such as grit, perseverance, grace, and determination. And I think everyone in the audience could add to this list. Getting to this point, going through what you have had to endure is accomplishment in and of itself. The question I have is this: what are you going to do with it? Someone once said, "The fireworks begin today. Each diploma is light as a lighted match, and each one of you is a fuse. No matter your path after this evening, whether it is a two-year tech school, community college, military, college, university, a gap year, or right into the workforce, remember this: you matter. You determine your path, and you will do great things, and most importantly, as stated by Judy Garland, always be the first-rate version of yourself instead of a second-rate version of somebody else." We would be remiss if we did not take a moment to thank the many people that have helped you along your path to tonight. To the moms and dads, friends and families, these young people would not be here without your love, support, and the occasional nudge of encouragement. Thank you. To the entire staff of the Forest Lake Area Schools who kept the wheels on the buses rolling, the lights on, food prepared, phones answered, thank you. To the teachers, thank you. Thank you for doing the impossible during the last year and a half. Through it all, you showed incredible grit, perseverance, grace, and determination, and that you have helped to navigate the multiple learning models. You did what you do best. You educated and supported with dignity and grace. Thank you. To everyone mentioned here and those that I may have forgotten, I thank you, and the class of 2021 thanks you. And finally, to the class of 2021, thank you as well for giving us the opportunity to get to know you, to teach you, to help create you who you are today. Go out and share the first-rate version of you with the world. Congratulations. At this time, I would like to invite our three student speakers to the stage: Amelia Hauer, Cadence Hitt, and Luke Osterkamp. They will be sharing their thoughts and reflections of the class of 2021. Please welcome to the podium Miss Amelia Hauer. Amelia will be attending the University of New Hampshire, where she will cross-country ski and will be majoring in pre-med or earth science. Amelia.
First off, before I begin my final commencement speech, I want to send a million thanks to each and every one of the faculty members. All of my teachers, the deans, my coaches, the athletic director, custodial staff, Mr. Caldwell, and most importantly, the Forest Lake community. Without everyone here in my life, I would not have had the opportunity to be up here representing the entire senior class, all 428 of you. And I want everyone to know I do not take this opportunity lightly and am beyond blessed to be up here. I hope to somehow sum up the greatest years of my life in these few minutes I have to share the lifelong lessons I have learned. And lastly, to send off the class of 2021 with an enlightening, bittersweet goodbye. The high school experience is incomparable for everyone, since we all come from different walks of life. But despite our differences, we all need to see that our paths, with whatever obstacles we had to overcome, led us here to the same finish line. We are all here as equals, graduating high school as one class and one community. Some of us here may not see that, but I like to see myself an optimist, and we all have a new journey ahead of us, a clean new slate. And what sets us apart after this is who has the intrinsic motivation. It is those who create their own opportunities, open their own doors to the greatness ahead. The textbook definition of intrinsic motivation is the act of doing something without any obvious external rewards. You do it because it's enjoyable and interesting, rather than because of an outside incentive or pressure to do it. An intrinsically motivated person is always proactive, creating new connections, bettering themselves. And they do not better themselves out of greed or selfishness, but rather the common fact that there is always room for improvement. You see, this was a lifelong, vital lesson I was taught and would like to pass along, because intrinsic motivation is the key to success. Everyone here should want to persevere, to be successful, to be unique, to be a good person. And what I mean by successful is not by wealth, but by aspiring to be the best version of ourselves. This will set us all apart from others in our future. Be confident in yourself, seek out your passion, and strive to be the best you can be. The best version of ourselves can be achieved by finding the equilibrium between our childhood lives and our maturing state. We must dream magnificent dreams to fuel our future motivation. Or in other words, by being both a dreamer and a doer, a simple concept I've held on to since seventh grade cross country season. And as my coach said, to want to be a champion is one thing, but to make it come true is another. You have to put the work in. He then read us a handout. Is it best to be a dreamer or is it best to be a doer? Actually, it is helpful to be both. A dream is of little value unless you can put action and do it, and it won't get you very far unless there is meaningful purpose behind it. Allow yourself to dream grand, magnificent dreams that express the deepest essence of who you are. Then let those dreams pull you through the nuts and bolts work of making them real. Work through each day with diligence and persistence, and as you do, stay close to the dreamer that always lives within you. As a dreamer, you can envision the world with no limits. As a doer, you can focus on something that has never existed before and make it real. Let your most treasured dreams focus your actions. Be both a dreamer and a doer. This message ties into everyone's lives right now. All of us are currently living the prime moments of our lives in this peak transition phase of being both a dreamer and a doer. We have dreamed our whole lives of what we want to become. It may be an engineer, a scientist, a doctor, an athlete, a chef, or the new Bill Gates. Who cares? Because it's your dream. But whenever it may be, set your expectations high and work hard to achieve them. Shoot for the stars, the moon, maybe even Mars. But now is the time that we take that leap of faith into the ring of fire. We may crash and we may burn, but we have to be the ones who rise from the ashes to make our dreams come true. The dream that I have, that I wish to come true, is to step foot on Mars. I've always had this desire to be the first to do something, have a lasting legacy. I want to leave this earth with more than I started with, that being a positive impact on others' lives, discovering new things, and putting smiles on people's faces. Also, I want to stand up for everyone, but especially those who defy the typical societal stereotypes. The stereotype I would like to address is those who are associated with being a nerd. And honestly, I think I can speak from experience. I would like to proudly say, I am a nerd, I am a bookworm, and I have a love for learning. And trust me, those things are not easy to write, and almost embarrassing to say up here, along with my dream of being an astronaut. But I must take this opportunity right now and make a statement and say, there is no such thing as being too cool for school. No such thing. Anyone who thinks this is foolish. The people who high schoolers should consider cool are the nerds. In other words, the students who devote themselves. I am using nerds as a broad expression of people who are unique, strive for success, have a love for learning, and seek to answer the unknown. These people are not about the high stigmas. Their intelligence shines through the charisma and speaks for itself. The nerds are the dreamers and the doers. They have a goal or a dream and they work for it. They persevere, they put the pedal to the metal. So I say we uplift the students who love to learn and we praise them for all their hard work and individuality, for they have the intrinsic motivation. In conclusion of this speech and of our high school chapter, I want us all not to live a life of I could have's, that I could have done this or I could have become this, because in the end, the I could have's add up to nothing. The things that make us whole are the journey to success, the grand memories we have, the unexpected great opportunities we never saw coming. We have one life, you guys, one life to dream and to do, and absolutely no time to waste on the I could-haves. We have already had 13 years of school and 18 years of magnificent life, and now it is time to take those few years under our belt and jump headfirst into a life of perseverance and greatness. We have already been through so much in these sacred few years of young adulthood that we are all well equipped to transition to the next glorious chapter in our lives. The last three things I have to say are to take the opportunities that come your way because you don't know where they will take you. Do everything with a wholehearted purpose. And lastly, make it a priority to come to the high school reunions because I want us all to share the incredible things we've all accomplished in our miraculous lives. And with that, I would like to sincerely say thank you, class of 2021.
Thank you, Amelia. Thank you, Amelia. Please join me in welcoming your Student Council President, Ms. Cadence Hitt. Cadence will be attending the University of Minnesota, where she plans on majoring in biology. Cadence.
Good evening, everyone. I want to personally welcome you all to the graduation of the class of 2021. What a year it has been. There have been so many setbacks and obstacles this year especially, but despite all odds, we all managed to graduate, and I think that deserves a round of applause. This is not the year any of us asked for or deserved. I want to thank all of the staff at Forest Lake High School, Principal Caldwell, Superintendent Massey, members of the school board, and of course the class of 2021 for doing everything they could to make this the best senior year we could possibly have. Now, I'm going to try not to bore you. We're all aware that the class of 2021 has an attention span of a toddler, too focused on scrolling through TikTok or answering Snapchats to listen and pay attention to the 30-second afternoon announcements. Sorry, Luke. I'll try to not make this speech as cheesy as possible, but bear with me, graduates. Fun fact, there are over 170,000 words currently used in the English language. That is a lot of words. Here are four. Forest Lake High School, FLHS, four letters for four words, but those four letters make up more than just four words. F stands for forest, but it also stands for family. We are all each other's family. Whether we liked it or not, we have seen each other almost every day for the past 12 years. Grown together, failed together, and everything in between. Which brings me to my next F word. And no, not the one you're thinking of. Failure. I'm sure every single one of us have failed a test before. I know Haley Pitzel and I ran into quite a few of those in sophomore chemistry class. Failure is normal. In fact, you should fail once in a while. It teaches us how to grow, and it builds successful people. We're all going to have many failures in life, and that's okay. Our futures are bright, and I have faith in every single one of us. L stands for lake, but it also stands for one of the most important parts about high school, lunch. I'm not even talking about what was being served in the cafeteria. I think all of us have eaten in class before, probably something like pretzels, fruit snacks, goldfish, granola bars, or maybe not. In algebra junior year, Tess Muscatelli brought food each day to eat in class. Things like sliced cheese right from the package and even baby food. I wondered what other weird items the class of 2021 had eaten in class, so I sent out a questionnaire, and here are some of the responses. Ramen noodles, a bowl of cereal with milk and everything, chili, peanut butter straight from the jar, cold spaghetti, an entire cheesecake, and you pretty much get the point. I think it's safe to say that in a high schooler's eyes, lunchtime is all the time. L also stands for legacy. We are all so pressured on leaving a legacy behind. We want people to remember us for years to come. However, I'll let you in on a little secret. You will not be remembered by how popular you were, how many likes you got on your Instagram post, or how many awards you won. You will be remembered as the kind of person you were. Whether it be the most kind, like our homecoming queen Maddie Roberts, the rowdiest ranger, like Caden Christensen, the most athletic, like Rachel Golnitz, or on the other hand, some of us will be remembered by how talkative we were in class. I'm looking at you, Lawrence, or as he likes to call himself, King Bo, and we don't even need a yearbook to remember that one. All of these things are going to leave a legacy, and the common denominator between all of them is being yourself. I know it sounds cheesy, but it's true. Live your own life, do what you want to do, and be the person that you want to be. That is a legacy. H is for high, as in high school, but it is also for help. We could not have made it here without the help from our teachers and parents, but most importantly, each other. Whether it be sending the homework answers to each other or doing each other's makeup for homecoming or prom, we depend and lean on each other when we need it. During the tradition of TPing the homecoming court's houses, one of our classmates' cars got stuck in a ditch. I will not be mentioning their name, but graduates, you know who I'm talking about. Our entire class came together to push their car out and successfully get it back on the road. It was such a special moment we shared. We put aside our differences and drama to come together as one to help a fellow classmate in need, and in that moment, I have never felt more proud to be a ranger. H also stands for home. A home is not just a physical place. It's a special feeling inside of us. Home means a future. It's a base where everything begins. We began as little 5 and 6 year olds, not even knowing how to read, and now look at us. Some of us are going to college, into the military, starting a business, beginning a full-time job, and doing so many other incredible things. We grew up in this place, and now we can look beyond our comfort zones and decide where we want to go. Home is a safe space. It's acceptance, a sanctuary, a place where we can be ourselves. Home always welcomes you with open arms. This is our home. Land of the free, home of the Rangers. No matter what you all decide to do after today, you will all still be a Ranger, now and forever, and that's a pretty special thing. S stands for not only school, but also sorry. It's what we say to our teachers when we forget to do the homework, to our parents when we get a bad grade, to our friends when we hurt their feelings. It's even sometimes what we say when we walk into the bathroom and accidentally interrupt a group of sophomore girls doing the renegade for a TikTok. Whether sincere or not, we have all said that simple word many times. It's because we make mistakes. High school was a time for us to learn right from wrong, a time to find ourselves, to figure out who we really are. It was meant to be a place where we could make mistakes and learn and grow from them. Hopefully, after these past few years, you have learned how to not have to say sorry that often. Finally, S stands for story. We all have a story, and this chapter of our story is now over. We're all guilty of counting down the days until this exact moment. However, now that we're finally here, it feels so bittersweet. Leaving such a huge part of our lives behind is a hard thing to do, but this isn't the end. This is the beginning of the next chapter. Whatever that next chapter may include for you, never forget that we were all once part of the same story. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2021.
Thank you, Cadence. Our final speaker for this evening is Mr. Luke Osterkamp. Luke will be attending the University of Northwestern St. Paul, where he will participate in their music and theater programs, majoring in communications. Luke.
Good afternoon, Forest Lake High School, and I'm Luke Osterkamp. Luckily for all of you, you will never have to hear me give the afternoon announcements again. I'm, of course, kidding. I know none of you actually listen to the afternoon announcements. I would, however, like to welcome you all to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2021. I want to thank all of the families and friends that have come to support these incredible students in front of me. We all wouldn't be the people we are today without your continued love and support. I would also like to thank the wonderful faculty, including all the members of the school board, Superintendent Massey, Principal Caldwell, and all the teachers and custodial staff. Thank you all for not only putting this whole ceremony together, but also for being the individuals who were there for us when we struggled, celebrated us when we succeeded, and made this high school the truly special place that it is. I think I can speak for all of us when I say that you are not the heroes we deserved, but the heroes we needed every time we walked through those doors. Thank you. However, today is the truly special day that it is, because I have the honor of congratulating the graduated class of 2021. We made it through the elementary playground, middle school growth spurts, high school drama, and distance learning, the playground, of course, being the most stressful. We have sadly entered the final 5 minutes of our Disney Channel teen drama coming-of-age story, the graduation speeches. This great, incredible story that we have shared together is coming to a close. There was a time when I couldn't imagine that ever happening. I still can't, not really. I couldn't imagine the day I would sit in one of those chairs. Instead, I sat on the curb in sixth grade and watched in awe as the seniors decked out in maroon and gold ran out of the spirit bus to come give high fives and sing fun songs. I wondered how I could ever be as cool as those people. Well, I'm not going to stand up here and say that I'm now the coolest kid in high school, because that would be crazy. I'm not even claiming to be in the top 500. What I am here to say is that I saw the climax of their story and knew that I could do that someday. And I wanted to do that someday. I was hoping to repeat their moment. I didn't get to. None of us did. When I found that out, I was sad, disappointed. I had waited for so long to repeat that memory, only I was going to be the cool old senior, acting like an idiot in a crazy outfit. Each and every one of us have memories we'd like to repeat, that we'd like to make our own. It's not a bad thing, but when it doesn't work out, when I saw those kids in elementary school and dreamed about it until I had gone through junior high and high school and it never happened, what then? There's this incredible drive to recreate the things that make us happy. I think it's because we know it works. We can try something new that might make us happy, or we can do the thing we've already seen or done. I mean, why else would High School Musical, the series, be a thing? Stories we like can be great to relive, but if you watch a movie so many times, you miss out on the ones that you haven't seen yet. They could be better, so much better. Hallmark movies are great and all, guys, only until you haven't seen an actual rom-com. At some point, a new story has to start. Today is one of those days for us. We're in the last few pages of the book, and it's exciting, and we want to know if all the characters are going to make it, and we want to know how it ends. I always find it so easy to rush these pages. But let's not. Let's soak it in. Humidity and all. This is a big day for all of us. For some, it's the most important day of our lives, and for others, it's merely a final obligation to check off the list. Life is a collection of stories, and I don't know all of yours, and you don't know all of mine. The great thing about life is that we all have thousands of stories. Some good, some bad, some a little bit of both. This one will make up a part of who we are, and so will all the rest. Don't hold on so tightly to the good ones that you miss an even better tale. When I knew that I wasn't going to get that spirit bus moment, I cried. It's kind of funny looking back on it. I wanted that so badly, and yet, had I gotten it, I don't think I would be any happier than I am right now. I mean, I never had a Friday with a strict schedule. I spent most of them doing the homework at my girlfriend's house. Great things can happen when you look for them. This could be one of them. It could not. A lot of you are probably thinking, I am just so glad I'm not doing what that guy is right now. Whereas I'm thinking, my speech is almost over. The last time I'll perform for a crowd in this high school. I have a great story. I hope all of you do too. Because these are the last few moments of our Disney Channel teen drama coming-of-age story. But they are the beginning of your rom-com with Matthew McConaughey. Or your action comedy with Dwayne Johnson and Kevin Hart. Or your mystery, or your sci-fi, or God forbid, your horror movie. We are the main characters. So go out there and write some stories.
Thank you, Luke. This year's commencement speaker is Mrs. Jennifer Wagner, or Wags, as her students and athletes like to call her. Mrs. Wagner grew up in Brooklyn Park and attended Park Center High School, where she graduated in 1997. While in high school, Coach Wagner participated in soccer, basketball, and track. She received state honors in soccer and basketball and was a state participant in the 400-meter dash. She was a member of the National Honor Society and has the honor of being the first woman basketball player at Park Center to score over 1,000 points. Mrs. Wagner received her Bachelor of Science from the University of North Dakota in physical education and a minor in health. She was a four-time letter winner in women's basketball and was a national champion in 1998 and 1999, and has been named to the UND Athletic Hall of Fame not once, but twice. She received her master's degree in education from St. Mary's in 2005 and a license in health from Bemidji State University in 2009. Mrs. Wagner began her teaching career in 2002 at Andover before being hired here in Forest Lake at Century Junior High to teach PE and be the head girls basketball coach in 2005. In 2011, she transferred to the high school where she has continued to be the head coach of the girls' basketball team until she announced her retirement from coaching in this spring. Mrs. Wagner and her husband Brad got married in 2003 and have three wonderful children, Tyler 14, Carolyn 10, and Drew 9. Coach is also a three-time cancer survivor. She defeated thyroid cancer in 2008, a melanoma in 2011, and she is just finishing her treatments for breast cancer after being diagnosed in June 2020. Mrs. Wagner models for this class and exemplifies grit, perseverance, grace, and determination. She enjoys being active and watching her three kids grow in their own passions, and she is ready for whatever life is going to throw at her next. Please join me in welcoming Mrs. Jennifer Wagner.
Thank you, Mr. Caldwell. I'm so honored to be here tonight, humbled to have this opportunity, and quite honestly, a little bit nervous as I've listened to many other speakers in the past, and I'm not quite sure if I fit in those categories of those other speakers. Yet here we are in one of my favorite places in our school, the main gym, a place where I love teaching all of you, a place where I've been fortunate enough to coach many of you in basketball. And now as we sit here sweating, because I'm sure all of you are, because I am, trying to manage through this heat, this is your moment. Everyone in this gym has been part of your journey in some way, and all of us are so proud of your accomplishment. So what's next? I've always enjoyed being on a team, the interaction with the people you are working with, working towards a common goal, and even when things get difficult, working together always seems to make things a little bit better. Much of my enjoyment of being on a team drove me into education. The relationship piece of being a teacher, I believe, is really, truly special. While building these relationships through teaching and coaching, there are always so many life lessons and teachable moments, and I'm sure everyone is familiar with many of them. The essence of hard work, dedication, perseverance, the list goes on and on. But add this to your list, toughness. I wish I could say I read more or even read a fraction of the books that Mr. Zemanski reads all simultaneously, which is quite impressive. But however, I usually only find myself reading while on an airplane or on vacation. And a few years ago, I read a book called Toughness by Jay Billis. This book struck my interest as Jay Billis is a basketball commentator who I enjoy listening to. I love his perspective of the game of basketball on players, coaches, and overall his viewpoints of life. His Twitter game needs a little work, but as a former basketball player at Duke and a coach there as well, I always have gravitated towards him. He wrote his toughness book based on an article he wrote for ESPN about what toughness means. The article was specific to basketball, and he discusses 30-some basketball-related concepts that all tough players are able to do, or at least attempt to do, in order to be more successful as a player and a team. I believe toughness matters because sometimes life is hard, usually not fair, but toughness helps individuals to push back when life can be overwhelming and still allow you to find joy. I realize not everybody in this gym is a basketball fan. However, there's one phrase that tough people practice, and when reading Jay Billis's book, I believe that it can be relatable to much more than just basketball. Next play. The game of basketball is very fluid, should be attempted to play at a faster pace, and tough players know that there's not enough time to celebrate every great play or every angry frustration. Regardless of what some of our famous NBA players might do when they play, the game just moves too fast, and it will move past you if you waste time arguing with an official or celebrating every made basket. Moving to the next play allows you to be better prepared for whatever is coming next. This does not ignore the importance of the previous play, as I do believe it's important to learn and grow from experiences, both good and bad, and those experiences help shape our next play. You cannot move past something and expect the next time. You cannot move past something and expect to get better the next time without actually allowing the importance of it to set in. Something that is true in the game of basketball, and with life experiences. I attended the University of North Dakota, was on the basketball team like Mr. Caldwell mentioned. My freshman year, I barely played. This was difficult for me because in high school, I had a much different role than sitting on the bench. After the excitement of the first couple of months of college wore off, and it set in that I had to do my laundry all the time by myself, I remember calling home and talking with my parents, sharing with them how difficult it was sitting on the bench, wanting to play, and I listened to my parents encourage me to trust my coach, work hard to be a coachable athlete, enjoy being on the team, and know that if it was easy, it would not be as memorable. I knew that quitting was not my next play. Instead, I was able to grow into a three-year starter, win two Division II national championships, and form friendships with some of my best friends. The struggle was worth it. Many of you in this gym know my more recent story. This past year was difficult. Besides the pandemic and learning models and trying to teach through Google Meets, I was diagnosed with breast cancer last June. I believe strongly in being proactive with your health, and a routine mammogram led me to an ultrasound and a biopsy 2 days later. On a Friday at 5:04 p.m., a doctor called me to tell me I was diagnosed with breast cancer, and I had to wait until Monday to get further information. Great, really? So this is my next play? Now I have to wait all weekend? Being patient is not something I would call a strong characteristic of my personality. So waiting the weekend for my next play was difficult because I would never use the word patient to describe me. However, I would use the word tough. I knew regardless of what was coming my way, I could attack it. And when I felt a little run down from chemo, from frustrations with radiation, and this hormonal treatment that has sent me into menopause with these nonstop hot flashes, I had a support system with my family and friends to lift me up. This is what makes your next play manageable. Realizing that you are strong enough. Sometimes life just makes you prove it. So you already know I'm not an avid reader. I might not have been repping one of those literacy cords when I graduated from high school like so many of you are now, but I do enjoy working out. And last spring, during COVID, I started running more frequently. While listening to different podcasts and Audible books, I've always been a firm believer in the statement that everything happens for a reason. However, during one of my longer runs late last summer, I heard a quote from Rachel Hollis that resonated even more with me, especially given at the time I just started chemo and I had recently shaved my head. She says, "I believe in the ability to find purpose, even in the absence of explanation." The quote legit stopped me and made me pause to process, as I do believe you can have purpose without that explanation, especially in times like now that can be more challenging. Good reminders to pause, listen for understanding, and breathe. Even with the life challenges I have faced, I have learned to embrace my scars and life's battles a little bit more, and to be more willing to share my journey. As a result, it helped me to build lasting connections and provided me strength, hopefully doing the same for others. Although I do miss rocking my ponytail every day and be able to have my dry shampoo as my go-to, as with my other life scars, my hair will grow back and fade away to better prepare me for my next play. And as you leave here from Forest Lake for your next play and the play after that, the educator and mom and me cannot just send you on your way without giving you a little bit of some advice and some tips that make discovering your next play manageable, meaningful, and enjoyable. Number one, own your strengths. Like, really own it. Be okay with recognizing what you're good at and how you can bring value in everything you do. I'm super type A. I like things organized, clean, and I do not like clutter. All of my basketball players know that basketballs are always placed on the rack. They're not left on the gym floor, and if one goes missing, they all know how much it will cost to replace it. So ask some of them, they'll tell you. But as much as I would like to shut that down and be more spontaneous, it just isn't in me. So instead of trying to fix what is true to me, I own it. Organizing, cleaning, bulletin boards, special events at basketball games, all my jam, and I won't hesitate in saying I can do this. Number two, Have confidence enough to fail. It's okay to try new things and not be very good at it. Figure out if this is something you want to keep working on, or maybe you just don't like it. Just have the confidence to try. 3, and there's only 5, I promise. So 3, make sure your effort matches your expectations. This is a statement I use very often with my students and my basketball players. If you want to earn an A in class, make sure that you give A quality work. If you want to be a starter and win a section championship, make sure your effort in the off season, in the weight room, during practices are championship habits. 4, focus on what you can control. I've used this saying over and over again when coaching. Control the constants: defensive effort, execution of plays, communicating with your teammates, hustle. More recently, I've needed this reminder in my personal life. When I was first diagnosed with cancer, my mind would take me to the question of why me. Last June, at the age of 41, this was my 3rd cancer diagnosis. Thyroid in 2008, melanoma in 2011. But this time, I knew breast cancer would be much more difficult. With so many emotions processing and doctor's appointments and treatment plans, I knew I could not give any more energy to the diagnosis. It is what it is. And I needed to focus on how I would respond, what I could control, and pour my energy into very intentionally controlling my controllables. And my initial question of why me led me to why not me? Difficult, yes, but this was my next play, and I was tough enough for it. Last one, 5. Time is a gift. When I say that, I honestly feel like my mom. As I run around with my 3 kids, driving them to their 1,001 activities and thinking to myself, I'm a glorified shuttle bus driver, and her saying to me, soon enough you will miss this. Soon enough you will miss Senior Square, the Friday night lights, having band class right in this gym, and the practices preparing you for greatness. Be intentional about finding joy in the journey. Life is not a destination. Work to pursue your passions and live in the moment. And as you start to recognize and see where you need to tell yourself to work for your next play, I would encourage you to always remember the previous play. Remember where you came from. And although right now you might not realize how special of a place Forest Lake is, this place helped shape you. Everyone in this gym took part in your journey, however big or small, and all of us here are so proud of your work to get to today. Forest Lake is a community that is big enough to provide options with classes and activities and clubs, yet small enough to give all of you opportunities. A true community that I am proud of. I want to thank you for allowing me to be part of this play, and I wish you nothing but success on your next play and the play after. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you, Mrs. Wagner. Graduates, we're almost there. Dr. Massey, Board President Peterson, and the rest of the Forest Lake Area School Board, at this time, together with Kelly Lafine, Principal of the Forest Lake Area Community School, it is our honor and privilege to present to you the class of 2021, having met all of the graduation requirements set forth by the Forest Lake Area School Board and the State of Minnesota. Please prepare the stage for the awarding of the diplomas.
careful.
You're just going to wait until I say your name and then we'll get you on stage, okay? Can you say your name?
Ladies and gentlemen, the first graduate of the class of 2021, Andrew Joseph Calcano.
Emma Marie Whitson.
Christina Lisbeth Ramirez.
Megan Isabel Wolf.
Luke Edward Kohlhaas.
Madeline Ann Zach.
Michaela Cora Bjork.
Katrina Marie Yeager.
Jade Geraldine Milligan.
Jennifer Huang Wood.
Maria Rose Shaw.
Bryce Gunner Westbrock.
Alexis Paige Nolan.
Nicholas Lewis Womack.
Anthony James Rausch.
Ethan Perry Zimmerman.
Robert Oscar Gaffney.
Adam Jules Witzel.
Logan Renee Anderson.
Lydia Grace Zimmerman.
Hope Catherine Anderson.
Molly Frances Zobitz.
Fru Inde Awasin Jr.
Joel Vladimir Zalea Chais.
Ali Abdi.
India Mylia Yang.
Annika Julie Amley.
Jasmine Gona Yang.
Vivian Elaine Algier.
Cindy Zhang.
Ethan Patrick Amon.
Abigail Deborah Will.
Mawa Hassan Arash.
Ellen Ivy Zupan.
Emma Marie Armitage.
Caitlin Elizabeth Wood.
Jadon Richard Arnold.
Ava Marie Wild.
Aaliyah Janae Anderson.
Trey Howard Zobrak.
Luke Michael Ahrens.
Nathan Arnold Yekout.
Grace May Ackerman.
Cameron John Zuniga.
Rebecca Ann Anderson.
Isabella Rose Berg.
McKenna Marie Andrews.
Zanaya Anaza Davis.
Sam Nels Anderson.
Kiara Lynn Smith.
Ben Andrew Anderson.
Ryan Scott Udd.
Paige Elaine Anderson.
Hunter Lane Urbanak.
Dominic John Augustine.
Luke David Albrecht.
Gage Richard Alton.
Sarah Jade Udston.
Natalie Marie Alvarado.
Indy K. Wallstrom.
Sophia Mohammed Abdullahi.
Haley Jo Zerwas, welcome.
Austin John Burgum.
Gabrielle Renee Wandersee.
Owen Matthew Berg.
Madeline Hope Welch.
Amanda Corinne Barsness.
Ashley Maitong Vang.
Bailey Darlene Babcock.
Jonathan Nathaniel Upshaw.
Paige Marie Babcock.
Caden Paul Walkerfuss.
Hallie Joe Beverly Baldwin.
Mariah Nicole Waddle.
Zachary Ty Baldwin.
Madison Beth Walters.
Jacob Darvin Bethke.
Anna Leslie Weiss.
Emma Jean Bergman.
Angelina Louise Ventimiglia.
Lillian K. Betker.
Jaden Christopher Watson.
Ian Hunter Bouch.
Nicholas A. Vincent.
Jack Thomas Bahi.
Cole Benjamin Wachter.
Nicholas John Belisle.
Brian Thomas Van Wagner.
Sabina Ann Barr.
Jack Adam Waldy.
Sophia Marie Biedney.
Andrew Fiorello Valentini.
Ariel Aurora Ball.
Owen David Wagner.
Paige Anna Bakasun.
Gosheng Ariana Vang.
Natalie Therese Berg.
Nucci Alyssa Vang.
Paige Mackenzie Bouch.
Lucy Vu.
Brianna Kate Betts.
Nathan David Werner.
Christopher Lane Beard.
Brody Allen Wagner.
Isabella Grace Battis.
Margaret Lynn Krinke Thompson.
Matthew Thomas Berg.
Carissa Lauren Thamert.
Mohammed Omer Barrento.
Carson Scott Thomas.
Layla Michelle Balfany.
Garrett Edward Taylor.
Daisha Tiana Bailey Voth.
Michael Bradley Tobritzhofer.
Logan Wesley Harlan Burrows.
Devin Michael Churchma.
Nicholas Adam Brown.
Zachary John Trotto.
Quinlan James Bonnet.
Walklin Ford Tinklenberg.
Quinton Lewis Karen.
Vincent Patrick Tarlizo.
Madison Noel Carpenter.
Francis Grace Tarlizo.
Brandon Alec Bush.
John Thomas Tarlizo.
Kevin William Bump.
Paige Kristen Swanson.
Abigail Nicole Buff.
Sarah Mary Tower.
Madeline Grace Bromert.
Cole William Swan.
Emily Reese Bromert.
Megan Elizabeth Tetzloff.
Natalie Jean Brandel.
Maximilian Robert True.
Allison Charlotte Bissler.
Kristen Rosella Swanson.
Cassandra Ray Bradshaw.
Nathan Michael Severson.
Jordan Gregory Van Dyke Boyson.
Carter Edward Tiesfeldt.
Tyler Richard Brischke.
Andrew David Sikora.
Megan Lynn Carlson.
Austin James Trailer.
Trenton Ryder Burkhalter.
Garrett James Swanson.
Lydia Rose Bostrom.
Dylan Robert Simons.
Emma Lee Brust.
Morgan Elizabeth Slowinski.
Samantha Jean Borboom.
Adam Connor Schoberg.
Lawrence Andres Bow.
Jason Jerome Sieber.
Connor David Brust.
Jared Patrick Sternagel.
Derek Jeffrey Cardinal.
Landon Lee Steen.
Mason John Devine.
Annie Jean Steves.
Caden Wesley Christensen.
Catherine Veronica Stafford.
Seth Kenneth DuPaul.
Trevor Daniel Scopian.
Cole Alexander Decker.
Christopher Ronald Steffens.
Connor Robert Clark.
Luke Thomas Sieben.
Isaiah Michael Dressel.
Kelly Joe Sullivan.
William Peter DeWitt III.
Jenna Oliva Stockinger.
Ella Grace Coleman.
Sebastian Isaiah Studier.
Benjamin Paul DeRozier.
Michael Allen Slavic.
Kaylee Christine Cassidy.
Madison Jean Siebenaller.
Samantha Marie Clark.
Derek Gary Schosted.
Jacqueline Nicole Clausen.
Grace Elizabeth Salmonson.
Nathan James Chanick.
Caitlin Ann Stanius.
Madeline Melissa DeMars.
Ella Nicole Stewart.
Brendan Robert Chenard.
Michael Thomas Sopp.
Logan Chase Collins.
Jackson David Steele.
Kevin Frederick Dome.
Jacob David Scherer.
Keith Everett Crone.
Tony Scarpone.
Pai-Ying Chang.
Christian Freedom Ross.
Haley Jean Danaski.
Allison Louise Sanders.
Micaiah Elise Dale.
Yossi Scott.
Salvatore Anthony Coviello.
Drew William Sampson.
Parker James Deo.
Thomas Stephen Chesso.
Dairo David Davalos.
Kason Dion Save.
Olivia Marie Furterer.
Zachary Thomas Ruger.
Madeline Ruth Galatowicz.
Kyle Scott Schwartz.
Madison Marie Fagerland.
Joshua Scott Schlichting.
Elena Ann Forlady.
Jack Ryan Schlickman.
Logan J. Giles.
Jack Martin Schultz.
Jocelyn Regina Ferrier.
Logus Thomas Runch.
Faith Catherine Fitzhugh.
Sophia Ann Marie Schwartz.
Angela Marie Ebsen.
Chloe Rose Scully.
Jack Maxwell Gabrick.
Abigail Lacey Seidel.
Jacob Donald Gervais.
Jocelyn Rose Sandstrom.
Samuel David Gierke.
Justin Connor Schreier.
Reese Orion Eck.
Andrew James Schaefer.
Farouk Abdul Qadir Elmi.
Jacob Joseph Sawyer.
Ian Duane Fockler.
Mariana Rose Ralston Dorer.
Abigail Renee Goodwin.
Andrea Rocha Navarrete.
Paige Patricia Herrer.
Blake Allen Rasmussen.
Madison Lynn Gedke.
Matthew Aaron Roche.
Jordan Shea Hamilton.
Nathan Bradley Reeder.
Annika May Haley.
Harris Eckert Ritter.
Madison Lynn Hegler.
Joshua Paul Redepenning.
Joshua William Hastings.
Nicholas Andrus Hella Ramberg.
Stephen Robert Goodnow.
Victoria Grace Rangich.
William Edward Albrecht Grams.
Isaac Matthew Roars.
Maverick Dennis Hawkins.
Maddie Rose Roberts.
Tyler Joseph Hayes.
Jacob MacArthur Rivard.
Zoe Marie Hawthorne.
Tyler Vern Rahway.
Fasia Hassan.
Joseph Dell Pratt.
Amanda Jade Hanowski.
Natalie Rose Runquist.
Sarah Ann Gutz.
Shelby Marie Wingwelski.
Dylan Michael Hoffner.
Austin Tyler Radke.
Maxwell John Gokin.
Demarian Reed.
Matthew Lee Greenfield.
Cody Lee Rawlings.
Amelia Erin Hauer.
Rachel Ann Cavetto.
Rachel Lane Golnitz.
Sarah Renee Pillart.
Tiana Renee Higgins.
Caitlin Marie Prisabilla.
Hunter Daniel Herman.
Logan Sampson Rachel.
Mitchell James Nesseth.
Joseph Douglas Olson.
Ryan John Hirung.
Luke Werner Osterkamp.
Eric Michael Henriksen.
Jenna Lind Peterson.
Elizabeth Marie Henches.
Catherine Ann Page.
Isaac Gawan Himraj.
Ishan D. Patel.
Alexis Mary Hovey.
McKenna Rose Olson.
Grace Lauren Heckerel.
Olivia Jean Olson.
Ariana Marie Holman.
Allie K. Organ.
Cadence Marie Hitt.
Jonathan James Obar.
Katie Diane Hogan.
Therese Catherine Ostlin.
Augustus Charles Herman.
Christina Marie Aschenbauer.
Olivia Linda Peckren.
Jacob Thomas Orthaus.
Xavier Alexander Heimerl.
Aiden Broderick O'Brien.
Kaylin Abby Holshue.
Emma Lorraine Peterson.
Robert Allen Holshue.
Claire Elizabeth O'Gorman.
Slade Matthew Heald.
Lauren Nicole Palmer.
Kalia Aviana Johnson.
Haley Patricia Pitzel.
Kaylee Sue Johnson.
Chase Robert Osterberg.
Alyssa Christine Young.
Connor Michael O'Gary.
Hannah Ariane Hoyland.
Caitlin Andra Peck.
Nicholas Robert Jorgensen.
Ashley May Peck.
Andrew John Jorgensen.
Stephen James Pavlik.
Blake Thomas Johnson.
Caitlin Ann Navarra.
Abigail Jean Jones.
Grace Elizabeth Mjolnir.
Natasha Rhea Jensen.
Tess Antonia Moscatelli.
Caitlin Nicole Kaup.
Mackenzie K. Nickaboyne.
Zachary Ryan Lee Hubbard.
Gina Sengyung Mua.
Luke Allen Johnson.
Kylie Nicole Nelson.
Adam Henry Jacobson.
Emma Rose Nordstrom.
Reed Emmanuel Hultman.
Emma Jo Newcomb.
Eden Lee Hoyt.
Mia Nguyen.
Hunter Jacob Johnson.
Wyatt William Nelson.
Jacob Marshall Ipe.
Connor James Neeser.
Jamie Lynn Ipe.
Erica Rosemary Nephew.
Josie Sue Call.
Zachary Scott Nelson.
Caitlin Michelle Johnson.
Benjamin Charles Neiman.
Eric Andrew Ivester.
Jeremy Fuktong Nguyen.
Jonathan Obert Huderlich.
Marshall Taylor Moon.
Michael Stanley Karen.
Anwar Ahmed Mohammed.
Riley April Jepson.
Lucas Daniel Modine.
Ryan William Jones.
Ryan Donald Nyhart.
Abby Jones.
Kennedy Christiana Mayer.
Emily Johnson.
Ashlyn Rose Makowick.
Kinsey Madeline Larson.
Aiden Ford Lux.
Max David Kelly.
Bergen Elton McJames.
Adam John Kennedy.
Jackson Adam Millette.
Riley James Larson.
Dominic Jeffrey Mikrit.
Noah Michael Kazak.
Logan Kelly McGrew.
Thomas Dwight Kurz IV.
Dylan Michael Marcellus.
Thomas Joseph LaBelle.
Ava Rose McGarver.
Regan Elise Klingberg.
Sophia Floreen Lizoft.
Mason James Labar.
Mandy Lynn McEnruth.
Samuel Robert Larson.
Olivia K. Mitchell.
Jordan Isabel Klund.
William Thomas McMahon.
Kaya Stephanie Conan.
Jordan Isaiah McNamara.
Gabriella Angeline Neeland.
Michael Paul Marty.
Paige Elizabeth Kulik.
Ethan Warren Matei.
Grace Ann Land.
Elvin Akongse Ma.
Claire Sylvia Kolstad.
Derek Darrell Marks.
Madeline Jean Kinney.
Ashley Jean McAlpine.
Sophia Ann Keys.
Jackson Stephen Moss.
Sumaya June Luger.
Lauren Lee Marsh.
Devin Saktoki Lohr.
Elise Anna Marquardt.
Sophie Ray Leonard.
Brady Patrick Metal.
Marvella Grace LaRue.
Marcus Roger Longsdorf.
Johanna Grace Livermore.
Tyler Edward Lashinsky.
Chaya Lee.
Logan John Lundgren.
Matthew David Livgard.
Caleb Matthew Lemire.
Ella Grace Lundy.
Madeline Kaylee LaRue.
Blake Richard Leach.
Kaylor Robert Leipzig.
Sean William Lash.
Charles Thomas Lenhart.
Ethan David Lundwall.
Austin Riley Latessa. Jack Adelord Legault.
Wait for it. I have one more speech. I'm just kidding. Congratulations, class of 2021. Congratulations, drive safely. You may exit out of both sides of the gym.